All Ends of the Spectrum, episode 41. I pulled a pen and piece of paper out of my bag and wrote down, how do I know if I am on the right track? I knew it was normal to feel lost at this age, but I couldn't be lost for long. The semester starts next week, and if I stayed lost for too long, I'd be in debt $40,000 with no job opportunity to look forward to. I stared at the question on the page for as long as I can remember. For as long as I can remember, writing gave me a sense of direction. I started every essay with a question, because Mother told me the answers I find are only as good as the questions I ask. If an answer is the treasure, the question is the tool you'll use to find it, she said. Use cheap tools, you'll find cheap treasure. I believed her, because if I formulated the question good enough, sometimes the answer came on its own. I was staring at the blank page when I heard a noise. Coming from my backyard. At first, I ignored it and tried to keep writing. Mother told me that destiny calls to us.
The next day.
Sweetly, like a mother calling her kids inside. But if we ignored her, she would get angry. She told me it's best to visit destiny before she calls. It's just kind. I decided to get it over with quickly. Like ripping off a band-aid, I swung it open. Outside it was dark. There was no one. There was no sign of anything. I needed to have an extra look. As I turned my back to go inside, I saw a blue light shining underneath a towel on the chair near my door. I removed the object. Underneath the towel was a crystal ball, shining, emitting a gentle blue light. When I had a closer look, I saw a beach. Inside, the waves ricocheted back and forth. The seals took flight.
Much, much, much later.
The sun descended over the ocean, but then the image vanished. Smoke started swirling.
Meanwhile,
and it became warm to my touch. I worried it would explode. I put it back in the towel and ran inside, waiting for the sound of explosion. But instead, I heard nothing. I went back outside. I grabbed the crystal ball and looked closely. I saw a newspaper with a list of best-selling books, and my name was on it. The image faded into smoke. Had the crystal ball shown me the truth? It must have. How else could it have known I was a writer? I formulated the question, and the answer really came to me. Mother told me life is a game of sacrifices. You sacrifice the future for the present, or you can sacrifice the present for a better future. But you have to pick one. She's right.
She's right. She's right.
Mother's always right. I took a seat at my desk.
A few minutes later,
pulled out my phone and saw a text message from Natalie. She asked if I wanted to hang out today. I told her I will be very busy for the next few days. I shut off my phone and put it away. Hours after hours gone by, I wrote down word after word. I didn't get up unless I had to use the bathroom. 16 hours passed. Finally, I put the pen down. I had written 5,000 words total. I walked over to my bed and collapsed. I felt lonely and exhausted. Mother told me a good sacrifice is painful. It's like going to the gym. A little bit of pain makes you stronger. But what about a lot of pain, I thought. I decided I was being a baby. If you run from pain, you'll never be everything you could be. When I woke up the next morning, I started writing, and after a few hours, my hand cramped. So I took a small break to play with the orb. A goal is a destination, and habits are the roads. If you have faith in the destination and faith in the road, then you will get there. You can drive forever, Mother said. I started writing again. I didn't put down the pen until 1 a.m. When I woke up the next morning, I saw the orb shining. I threw the blanket and ran over for a closer look. I felt like I saw water for the first time. I picked up the ball. My heart raced faster and faster as the smoke cleared. I saw myself at a bar, by myself, crying. Why was I crying? The image faded, and another emerged. Divorce papers. I forgot about Natalie. The ball went dark. I put it on my desk. I turned to my phone. I had 4 missed calls, 9 text messages, and 3 voicemails. I had to give her a call. Oh my God, Kareem, you're alive. I tried calling you so many times. Is everything okay? I was worried. I've been busy working on this novel and work, trying to make a better future for us. Her, you're burying yourself in your work. This isn't healthy. We have to talk about this. Can I see you? Me, I'll be over soon. She said I'll be waiting and hung up. I spent the rest of the night at her house.